What's up, everybody? DJ Marlino and Roz here, and we are with two amazing people on MYX, the beat of our culture, our stories, our music, uniquely Filipino, and I'm so proud and excited. I've been waiting for this interview for the past 2 weeks. I keep asking every single day, is it today? Yeah. So I'm so excited to have Nicole Scherzinger here, as well as my brother, Troy Laureta. What is up, you guys?
Hi, aloha.
Hi, Ate. So, Nicole, the last time we saw each other was at Will.i.am's house. It was for an interview with MySpace.com. And he told the story of how he wanted you a part of the Black Eyed Peas early on. And remember that? It was so funny.
Yeah, actually, I was a big fan of the Black Eyed Peas back then. And I was in a group called Eden's Crush before.
Of
and
course.
We had scored together. So I was like, I'd used to go past their dressing room and be like, jumping music, Swifty J's, smoke machines, and laser rays. And like, be like, hey guys. And yeah, Will actually wanted me to become, this was before Fergie ever came into the picture, but everything works out divinely because she's the perfect P. And then I was supposed to be the, you know, Pussycat dolls.
The queen. And, you know, J Rey Soul is also there, another pinay that's singing with the peas right now. But you talked about Edith.
Yes, and she is killing it, honey.
Yeah. Killing it. I like that you brought up Eden's Crush because I don't know if you remember that time period, but you were that first pinay on TV where all of us felt like represented. You know, we would tune in every week and like just seeing you through that process and then becoming a part of the Pussycat Dolls. I specifically went to a Denver Black Eyed Peas show so I could watch the Pussycat Dolls on that specific tour. So, you know, even early on and now recently, we worked with ANA, AIMM, and TW and Company for the See All, you know, commercial that you were in during the Emmys, specifically about diversity with Lin-Manuel and Billy Porter. You know, do you ever stop to think about how much you've meant to just the Filipino or Filipina community worldwide and how you were that first person that we saw? And you know, now you're killing it everywhere. TV shows everywhere.
First of all, thank you, sis. It means a lot that you say that. And honestly, I don't think I ever really truly did stop to think, but now that you mention it, it makes a lot of sense, you know, because growing up, my idols were, you know, people like Lea Salonga. I looked up to Lea Salonga. I was obsessed with her voice, and wanted to be in Miss Saigon so hard. And then, you know, people like Paula Abdul, Mariah, because they were just different looking. So it would make sense because, you know, there's more role models now these days, but back in the day, there wasn't as many, you know, that were so diverse.
And you had an amazing career and an exciting career at that, you know, just loved watching you on TV. And just even like, I was there when Pussycat Dolls, when we broke that record up in San Francisco at Wild 94.9 back in the day. So just seeing the process of, you know, where you came from, where you're going and where you are now. I'm curious to ask, with this OPM album or project, what is it about this project that is the most special to you?
You know, this is a dream of mine. I've always wanted to be a part, to be able to give back to a big part of who I am. I might not be as versed as Troy on all of this, but, you know, I love my Filipino family. I love the heritage and the culture. And this was for the first time, it, just like when I was able to be a part of Moana and give back in that essence, you know, it made me really proud when Troy was so kind to ask me to be a part of this. I was just honored because I was like, it's a dream to sing in Tagalog. I've always wanted to. Will you help me? You know, so that's important. It's important to go back to your roots. It's important to go back to your people, your blood, your ancestry, and to give back and to represent and to be. God gave me this voice for a reason. You know, just shining a light on where I come from, because you know Filipinos can sing, honey.
Now, aside from singing in Tagalog, can you actually talk fluently in Tagalog too, or no?
Oh gosh, no.
Okay, good. We're in the same boat. So.
Well, we're gonna manifest because you said. You said Lea Salonga is one of your favorite. We just talked about Nandito Ako before you walked in, so we're manifesting. Alea and Nicole collab for Nandito Ko 2022, okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, Nicole, you talked about your Hawaiian culture, you know, and, you know, we were just in Hawaii shooting a music video for a song called Chicken Adobo by Guapdad 4000 and Illmind coming out soon. I can't wait for you to hear it. But, you know, talk a little bit about that, about how it was to grow up Filipina American in Hawaii. And then, you know, you also moved to Kentucky. But, you know, now this process of people getting to see this song, your community in Hawaii, your community worldwide, and then, you know, what it means to just create. Trey, pronounce it for me. Pangako. Pangako, which means promise, you know, but just for all your communities worldwide.
Well, you know, being born Hawaiian, Filipina, it's just like, I feel like God just, you know, it was such a blessing because there's not many Hawaiian Filipinas, right? And I feel like Hawaiian Filipinas are like the same, one in the same. And, but I, at an early age, I was then raised in the mainland. Mm-hmm. And so, but I would always go back home and all my family is from there. And it, for me, it was just one and the same, the family, you know, Hawaiians mm-hmm. and Filipinos are so similar. They're just so full of heart. They're hearts of gold, such loving people, so rich in their culture and in their heritage. And I just feel really blessed that I get to be the best, hopefully the best of both worlds.
And just the song Promise, like how did it feel recording that song? You know, or Pangako, also known as Promise.
I'm not gonna lie, that's a real, it's a real song right there, guys. That's a real, real, real nugget of the song. It's got some meat to it, that song. That's like
Trey picked them. He picked the good ones.
It was like I said, it was an honor that he chose that song for me to sing because that was like, I feel like it's like the Whitney Houston's I Will Always Love You. I loved it. It's part of the reason why I think God gave me this voice is to sing music like that. And especially a song like that, right?
Yeah.
The way that it was written, the words, you know, the meaning behind it and then where it goes. But I definitely could not have done it without Troy and Chessa, his sister. but it was really awesome. It was really empowering. And like I said, a dream come true for me to be able to sing in Tagalog. And hopefully I did it justice, though.
What are you talking about? Like,
you did it justice, sis.
The first person to hit me up was Apple from my life. Apple was so happy. He was like, yes, sis.
He's been waiting. You know, Nicole, you could sing a Jollibee commercial and you would just kill it. Like, anything you sing is like fire.
Let's manifest that one. I can just manifest. Chicken Joy. Chicken Joy.
Apple, I was at Apple's house. He has a 12-foot Funko Pop Jollibee in his house. So we already know where we could shoot the music video for this.
I love him. I love him so much and everything he does for the Filipino community as well. He's so awesome.
So I got to ask you. So you, like Troy, put together an amazing collective of artists for the OPM project. How did you guys meet? I want you to describe what it was like meeting Troy. And then what were your thoughts, like the first thoughts that came to your mind when he asked you about this project and about being a part of it?
To be honest with you, I don't know if Troy remembers, but I was geeking out over him. My dear friend, David Foster, who was the first producer who produced Pop Stars, actually, come full circle, actually. That's so weird. He asked me, he said, music director that I'm working with, David Foster, if you can imagine, is like my musical director, is doing a show tonight, showcasing. I was like, you're a music director? You are the music director. Anyways, I came and I saw it, and it was Troy's beautiful show, and it was him and his beautiful band and singers coming out, and I was just floored. I had never seen or heard or experienced anything like that in Los Angeles, and the talent and the voices. And I said, who is that? Who arranged this? Who did that? And they're like, oh, it's this boy from, I think he's from Hawaii. He's from Hawaii. I was like, not even. No way. Like,
oh, I thought you guys knew each other in Hawaii. You did.
I was like, where is he? Because I've got to work with him. And then I think I was annoying. I think I fought my way backstage and was like, hi, can we work together? And I just kind of like was just obsessed with his talent and what he was able to do with music. And so then I asked him to be my music director, and he did. He's been working with me ever since, past few years.
Wow.
Nicole, I gotta share a story since like how we met during the project. And now that she's here, I think it's a funny story. I gotta tell it. But you know, we like Nicole said, we've been working together on a couple shows. And when I finally, you know, was putting together Kaibigan, I was sitting in, you know, like sitting in my living room, just zoning out. Like, I have this song, Pangako. I was telling my sister Chessa, like, I really think that Nicole should sing this song because she's perfect. She has the voice. She's gonna kill it. So I sat down, you guys, in that chair, and I was getting ready to call Nicole, and I was so nervous because, you know, we've only known each other for a year. So, you know, I'm never one to assume that, you know, we're going to work together or just do something, especially it's Nicole Scherzinger. So I turned on spa music in the background on TV, and I left her this, like, it had to be like an hour long voice note. And then it was funny because, of course, she said yes, but she also mentioned that, oh my God, next time you don't have to ask me for 1 hour and you don't have to have the spa music in the background.
He's playing keys. He's like singing, dear Nicole.
No, I was just really nervous, and I thought like spa music would kind of zone me out and, you know, make me feel more relaxed, you know, to ask her. So
Dude, that was like the 80s mixtape voicemail message things back in the day. Do you remember that?
I went 90s on Nicole. So
oh my God, but seriously, you guys should have heard this music. I was like, is either he's getting a foot rub or in the nature store right now, because I don't know what this music was cracking me up. Plus, like, I consider him family. You know when you have, like, the blood, right? You just family already. You just know. Yeah. You probably know, like, your aunts are the same as mine. It's all the same. So he left that message. I was like, this was way too long. And you know when your phone keeps cutting off, so you got to start all over with it?
Yes!
I was like, yes, of course. It would be my honor. And are you getting your feet rubbed or something right now? What's going on?
I love it. You got to post it. You got to find that message and post it.
Oh, my gosh. That'd be hilarious. So, Nicole, I've been watching, like, on your IG. I see all the food that you've been posting. So I have to ask you, like, the food that you post is, like, hella good. But I want to know, what is your favorite Filipino food?
I don't know a lot of Filipino food because of my Hawaiian background. So what is the chicken?
Adobo.
Chicken. What did they just made a song, a music video for?
Yes.
Can we send some chicken adobo to your house? Because I would love to send some.
Okay.
Of course. I'll make you some.
Here, I want to request something.
Make me some. You told me you're gonna make me some last time you were at the house.
I did. Don't worry.
We're gonna do something better. Let's do a potluck. All four of us. I will bring you my arroz caldo, which is, like, I've taken this everywhere. It's like a chicken porridge soup thing. And I'll make Bicol Express, which is, I'm not sure if you like spicy, but it's kind of like a coconut curry with chicken. And okay. Then yes. Troy will bring, I'm not sure what you're going to bring.
Troy, what are you gonna bring?
Oh, I'm going to bring adobo. I promised Nicole some adobo.
There you go.
Be good.
I'm gonna bring magnolia ice cream, some ube macapuno. You know, they have a lot of magnolias in Hawaii as well. And then yes. Apple the app, I'm sure he's gonna come up with something as well. He eats vegan Filipino food. He's the one that has all those recipes. But we're gonna bring it to either Nicole or Apple's or Troy's house. We're gonna play some spa music.
The universes were aligning when he was leaving that message. I was like, okay, I'm in.
Okay. So when
I love to eat. Well, you guys have to educate me. I can't wait.
Okay. Let's do this. When are you free? We'll talk about this after.
No, you know, you did talk about just like, it's meant to happen. And I hate to sound cheesy because I always do, but I really, truly believe this moment and this album and bridging the cultures, even from our ancestors, in how successful you are in the mainstream music industry. Nicole, you host every TV show ever possible, but you are like bringing it back, and you're bringing it back to your core. And this is bigger than all of us. You know, even this interview that's going to reach millions of Filipinos worldwide. Like, when I tell people you're Filipina, the pride in their eyes, they're like, what? No wonder she's so hot.
First of all, thank you. But it's an honor. You know, it's a big part of who I am. And when I went to the Philippines, with the Pussycat dolls, it was crazy legit. You would have thought we were the Beatles. You would have thought we were the Beatles up in that joint. Ed never felt so much love. And but when I went there for UNICEF to work with the children on the street, it blew my mind. And I'm not gonna get teary-eyed now, but like when I saw those children, I was looking in their eyes and I was like, you look like me. You look like me when I was growing up. And I could have, it could be like, you could, anything is possible. You know, God is so good. And I come from definitely very humble beginnings. And it's just an honor to be able to be a voice and a light for, like you said, where we come from, our backgrounds, our ancestors. So thank you.
Well, wow, that's a lot. You know, the first time I went to the Philippines was with Apple the App and Joe Coy and a bunch of us, Cassie and Leah Band. So it was that same feeling, you know, seeing your like, your ates, like, you know, digging from the trash and like seeing all the resources in the islands is like, how could it be so beautiful? But we have so much poverty. And I think, you know, your philanthropy work and what you're doing to give back, you know, I just want to say one last thank you from all of us, because I don't think that we've ever gotten to thank you for all of your work. And every day someone feels like they can do something because they see you, Troy, and you're behind Ariana Grande and Nicole, you're on TV. Like, we see one of us finally. And is there anything you want to say to your community, your Pinays worldwide, you know, salamat, mahalo, but you know.
Just like, just don't forget who you are, you know. God really shined a light on us. I think he spent some extra time on us, Filipino blood, you know what I mean? And don't forget who you are and go after, you know, if you really can see it and dream it and believe it, it will happen, you know, because like I said, and I know Troy is the same, we come from very humble beginnings and it's possible. And Lord knows anything about our culture and where we come from is we are the hardest workers and we got the biggest hearts, and that will definitely shine through and that will persevere at the end of the day. So I'm just grateful. I'm grateful to be on this beautiful masterpiece of an album that Troy has invited me on, and to be speaking with all of you today. And I love you all out there. You're freaking gorgeous, and keep shining.
Mahal kita, right? Mahal kita kayo. let's end on that. And I think not only with your beauty, but God has blessed you with one of the most beautiful voices we've ever heard of all time. And you've used it in a beautiful way to uplift 120 million Filipinos worldwide that needed to hear, you know, Pangako for promise for the future.
Oh, amen. Well, that's, we're doing our jobs then, aren't we? We all doing our jobs, the service. So thank you. It's all from my heart and my soul and my gut right there. Yeah.
We'll see you with our adobo, and
there's the front door. So,
and then I have one request. I don't want to sound like a groupie, but I have the biggest favor to ask. Can you follow me on IG? I'm putting it in the chat right now. There it is.
You guys have to follow me now.
Nicole, I'm already following you.
Well, Marlena, he just wants you to follow him because he hosts and he created the biggest Filipino hip hop and R&B podcast in the world. And some amazing talent has come through, you know, so he just wants you to see all of that.
Okay. Well, what is it?
It's right there. Heavy Rotation FM.
You really put it.
And then 5 Foot of Funk. I put it in the chat. And then Star's cutting us out now too. So we have to go soon.
All right. Salamat. Can we call you Ate? Ate Nicole.
Yes, please. Oh, I got it. Is this it?
Yep, that's it right there.
All right, they're cutting us off. Kuya Troy, we'll see you soon.
Thank you, Nicole.
Thank you, guys.
Troy, we'll talk to you soon.
All right, guys.
Bye, have a great day.